I'm Lenny Sorensen, and welcome to today's Tiny Lecture. Among my interests as a food historian is who cooked and who served the food and how that food was prepared in antebellum Virginia. When Edith Fawcett and Frances Hearn returned from to Monticello with the newly retired President Jefferson, the two enslaved women chefs had between them 14 years of experience cooking for the highest political elites of Washington City and the President's house. There, at his rural private home, Jefferson instructed his masons to build a large kitchen space containing a 16-foot hearth wall with a capacious bread oven. Hung from the right of the 5-foot hearth was a fancy French spitjack to turn roasting meats to perfection. With its waist-high masonry cooking surface and the large still kettle for hot water, this newly constructed unit was nearly the best culinary technology available in 1809. Only the recently introduced wood-burning iron cook stove was superior, and there were still very few of them. From young manhood, Jefferson had been interested in good food and architecture. To fulfill both those interests, in 1784, Jefferson took his young enslaved valet, James Hemings, to France to learn French cooking in the finest kitchens in Paris. A decade later, James Hemings returned to Monticello to teach his younger brother, Peter, the art of French cookery in a bargain for his own freedom papers. For the project, Jefferson added a masonry stove in the tiny kitchen below the South Pavilion. And it was in that kitchen that the two young girls, destined to become longtime Monticello chefs, began their life training, doing the work of scullions. And as the scullions, they would have brought water in and water out, used dirty water out. They would have cleaned and cut up vegetables. They would have stirred pots and carefully done so under the very watchful eye of Chef Hemings. And they would have learned things like what kind of firewood was necessary to build flame for the best cooking of each dish that was being prepared. And the dishes the chefs created were elaborate and very delicious, with really great names. Here are just a few. Beef a la mode, Scotch scallops of veal, curry after the East Indian manner with rice, almond pudding, pickled nasturtiums, Spanish fritters, and a really great name, salmagundi. 200 years after later, the newly restored Monticello kitchen hearth became a place of celebration. We lit that first fire in the restored hearth in the names of the chefs, the cooks, and the scullions, the yard help, and the dining room servants, whose work in bondage had contributed to the continuing reputation of Jefferson's table, where the food was described by one person who sat at his table as half Virginian, half French style, in good taste and abundance. Thank you.